Kawasaki mules have been around a long time. In fact, they started this whole utility vehicle thing long before it was popular. Mules have been used for years around farms and construction sites where the requirement was more to move men and equipment around the area than to just provide fun for the operator. Because of this, they were designed as sturdy, reliable workhorses. That means industrial engines and steel construction. Now, although the Transcab is a new model, it's still based on the proven technology and construction of the past models. Mules are available in both two-wheel drive and four-wheel drive. But because our requirements consist of a lot of varied terrain, our test model is the four-wheel drive. Prices for the Mule 3000 series starts at $74.99 for the regular cab two-wheel drive and $87.99 for the regular cab four-wheel drive. The regular cab four-wheel drive is also available with a diesel power plant that retails for $99.99. And the Transcab that we tested in gas power has a suggested retail price of $99.99. First, let's take a look at what makes a Transcab what it is. It's built on a wheelbase that is 11.6 inches longer than the standard cab Mule 3010. Now, that extra length results in a cab that is long enough to fit an extra seat. So now, in Transcab form, the Mule can easily carry four adults. Now, although there's not enough room in either seat to really let a six-footer stretch out, its intention is to carry these men from one part of a job site to another, not take them across country in a sightseeing vacation. The unique part of the Transcab, and the reason for its name, is that in just a couple of minutes, the rear seat can be folded forward and the Mule is transformed from a four-seat short bed configuration into a two-seat long bed setup. And then, just as quickly, back again. One of the most noticeable changes to all mules, at least to someone like me that's had a mule around the ranch for years, is that the tailgate and all the movable points like the bed swivel extensions and the headache rack are now more solidly mounted in rubber bushings to help keep the rattles down on rough and washboarded surfaces. The Mule is powered by a V-twin four-stroke industrial engine. The liquid-cooled two-cylinder displaces 617 cc's and transmits its power to the ground through a continuously variable transmission with high range, low range, neutral, and reverse. There's one knob on the dash to select either two-wheel drive or four-wheel drive, and another that allows a rear differential to be either open or locked. Now, the big advantage to the rear locker-unlocker is that in unlocked mode, the action of the differential allows the rear tires to turn at different speeds, so they do not tear up the dirt or the turf or whatever the surface that you're running on. And if you need more traction for muddy, slippery, or off-road excursions, just move the knob, lock in the differential, and voila! The rear works just like the rear of an ATV. The Transcab can haul 400 pounds of cargo in four-passenger short bed mode and 800 pounds when the bed is extended. It can also tow 1,200 pounds. But the magic question is not what it has, but how does what it has work? Climbing in, you'll find the seating comfortable, although a bit harder to get into and out of than the standard cab version. To start the engine, the transmission must be in neutral. Huh? Is it that big a deal to do? I mean, to make the engine start in gear? It would certainly make starting and stopping, like you do around a farm or a ranch or the job site, a much easier task. But once you put the tranny in neutral, the engine fires quickly. And then you'll find the true comfort of a mule. First, it's extremely quiet, almost like an electric golf cart, and smooth too, at least on fairly smooth surfaces. The limited suspension travel works well for slow and smooth going, but it's not well suited for sporty fun. And the engine is governed to around 25 miles an hour, just in case you wanted to anyways, but trust me, you wouldn't. All the operations are easy enough. The transmission shifts between low, high, forward, and reverse without any hesitation or clunks. The two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive, and locker knobs slide from one position to another without complaint. The steering doesn't require a construction worker to operate, and best of all, the parking brake is a handy hand lever just to the driver's left. Although the mule is equipped with a dump bed, trying to get it to dump with anything in it other than, a small shovel of dry manure is best left to the hired hand. Why? Well, the hinge point is located too far back to the rear of the bed. So if you need to use the dumping capacity of the bed, and you don't have that husky hired hand to lift the dump, you better plan on getting an electric lift system. The mule is a very, and I mean very, quiet and smooth operating utility rig. And all of the controls operate just as they should. Well, except for not being able to start in gear, that is. But one thing the mule Transcab is not, is agile. It's long, and it takes a large area to turn it around. And backing up almost requires you to have a swamper along giving you hand signals. Now, the best analogy that I can give is the difference between a regular pickup truck and a crew cab. Yes, the crew cab seats more people, but if you don't need that capacity, you'll be suffering every time you try to fit it in between the lines of a parking lot. And the same holds true for the mule Transcab. It's long and much more cumbersome than the standard cab models. So, if you need to carry four people around most of the time, this is the rig. If not, you'll probably be a lot happier with a standard cab. The good? Sturdy. Steel construction. Smooth operation and that handbrake. The bad? Doesn't start in gear. The dump needs assist. It's a long, long rig. The bottom line? If you need to haul four people around your work site or hunting lease, and you're not in a hurry, this is the perfect rig.